Hello, you're watching Proactive London. Tharisa PLC has signed an agreement for the development of a solar power plant to supply power to its Tharisa Mine in South Africa. Joining with more is Head of ESG at the company, Tebogo Matsimela. Tebogo, good to speak with you today.
It's an absolute pleasure, and greetings to everyone.
So, Tebogo, the agreement is with Total Eren and Chariot PLC. How will it work?
Look, I think we did realize that it's going to be a massive project, and you need the right partners on board to be able to come up with the implementation of this massive project. And we found the better fit to establish relationships with Total Eren and Chariot on the basis that they've got a track record of, especially doing such projects around the world. And they came as a strategic fit. And I think it's good to really start on that foot, and also to make the public aware that not everybody can do such projects on their own. We are a mining company. We're not in the solar space, and hence we had to partner with them. And this is a non-binding MOU, which means that the parties are still going to negotiate certain elements of the project. But the essence of it is that they're going to be our strategic partners in implementing the project.
So as I understand it, the MOU is a precursor to a long-term power purchase agreement for electricity, and that's on a take-or-pay basis. Is that right?
Yes, it is. I think you need to appreciate the fact that independent power producers do need some form of a commitment in terms of an offtake to say we're going to build, own and maintain this infrastructure, and there's an offtaker in place who is going to be buying the energy, and that will be Tharisa.
So Total Eren and Chariot will finance, develop, and also maintain the plant, and then they sell the power back to you.
Absolutely.
It's going to initially provide 40 megawatts at peak. Will that cover your energy requirements at Tharisa?
No, absolutely not. I think we're currently sitting at a demand of about 24 megawatts around the clock, and we are a 24-hour operation. And I think we all know that the storage technology, it's something that is being developed elsewhere around the world to come up with ways to store the power for you to be able to use during off-peak, because we all are aware that solar PV, it's not like your conventional CSP technology where you are able to store the energy and when, as and when it's required, be able to discharge the energy onto the grid or discharge it to the off-taker. But with the solar PV, that is not possible. So, during those peak hours when we are able, especially during the day, when we do need the power, we will be able to draw from the solar PV. But for off-peak times when there is no sun, you'll definitely be tapping onto the utility, which is your ESCOM. So our allocation from ESCOM will still remain the way it is. And as and when we need to tap onto the PV, energy will do that.
Tebogo, you've pledged to reduce carbon emissions by 30% by 2030 and be carbon net neutral by 2050. How far does this take you to your initial target?
It's a step into the right direction. I mean, if you look at the 30 megawatts, which is at peak would be 40, because our required is 40 megawatt alternative energy. I mean, alternating current, my apologies. But if you look at our energy demand, it will also absolutely bring the much required percentage to be able to remain on course for our milestone of 30% by 2030. I mean, if you're going to be bringing 30 megawatts worth of energy onto your energy mix, significantly it goes a long way. And I think it's also important to realize that based on our mine methodology, where we are an open pit mine, we do use a lot of tracking to get the ore body out of the pit onto your crushers and all of that. So you do have a quite large number of machinery that still uses diesel, but the initiatives that we actually embarking on to try and bring about a lot of efficiencies to reduce our carbon emissions, to reduce our diesel intake on a month to month. So we believe that the different initiatives that we currently busy with at the mine will definitely help us to meet our milestones 2030 and 2050.
Tebogo, thank you very much for the updates. I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress as you move towards those milestones. But thanks for speaking with us today.
Absolutely. And it's an absolute pleasure. And we'll definitely keep the market very much informed as to what is it that we're doing. Thank you.
Thank you. That's Tebogo Matsimela, the head of ESG at Tharisa PLC.